A very warm welcome and a good evening to yet another exciting episode of our technology show, Innovate. Even as we end this month of October, we bring you nothing but the best from the world of technology, both here in Uganda as well as globally. My name is Brenda Kimbawazi, but first, this is what we have on the show for you this evening.
This week on Innovate, we bring you Karen Ida, who came up with a brilliant idea of turning car tires into useful and beautiful furniture. The app Accelerate, where 14 entrepreneurs participated in the second cycle that supports young people addressing challenges in sexual reproductive health. And for Hacksphere, we tell you what VPN is, what you should look out for, and how it works. And for Globotech, we bring you 82-year-old Masako, who is one of the world's oldest iPhone app developers.
Now, waste tires here in Uganda are often improperly distributed or even disposed of, which is a potential threat to both our human health as well as the environment. But now a young graduate, that is Karen Ida, has found a solution to all of this by making beautiful furniture instead. Take a look.
In the outskirts of Kampala in Makindye Division Lower Fu Zone is where we met a young charming lady that does car recycling.
Chaze, Karen Ida, a student at Makerere University, pursuing a bachelor's in public administration, social sciences, but majoring in public administration. I'm finalizing with that course, and I'm an artist too. And I'm a born again Christian who goes to Watoto Church.
Earning from West, after making a table from an old car tire and selling it to an uncle, Karen Ida realized she could make some good money if she made more furniture from old tires.
I started this work in 2014, and that was after my dad had passed on and after A6, and I was home really doing nothing. I must say, really doing nothing, occupying me. Because my mom doesn't want me to work. She feared then that, you know, men in Kampala, you know, say this and this to her little girl. But so amidst all those things, my mind triggered to think outside the box. So I say to myself, you know what, you're an artist. And still I would not come up with anything to do, really. But not until my auntie, an auntie-in-law of mine, sent us pictures of flower vases made from tyre. So because there were some tyres at home from my auntie's car, I just decided to do a table. And then I came up with whatever I could and made a table. Glue, what stuff that's, you know, that wasn't very expensive, and made a table. But before that, the funds I used, I asked for my mom. Yes. So my mom is like, that's your money, so you know what to use it with. You can spend it the way you want. It was 150,000 shillings, if I remember correctly. And then when I did the table, I showed my uncle, one of my uncles. It was particularly his wife, but because they're one, I can say my uncle, because... So afterwards, my uncle bought it. And so I realized that this can make for me money, even when I'm at campus, even when I join campus. And this one, even when I do it, I don't have to go and work for someone and come back late in the evening. So I can do it at my free will and at my own time and my own pace. So I decided to do it. And then when I did it and took pictures of it and sent it to my friends, they're like, wow, this is cool, this is nice. Then I told them it was from tyre because I had concealed it with leather. So you couldn't easily tell, you know, someone. You had to tell someone that it was from tyre. And, you know, my friends liked it, but they didn't like the bit of tyre. They were just imagining how you get all those things and then put up a piece, eh? A girl child. They thought, oh no, we want to work in a boutique probably, or do some other things instead of doing this dirty work, I guess.
Even when she was mocked by friends for doing what they term as a man's job, Karen kept doing what she loved, which is car tire recycling.
I didn't care, I guess. I don't know why I didn't care, but I didn't, because somehow I knew that, you know what, these people don't feed me. They're not going to give me this extra money I need to go and watch a movie while at campus and to do all those things. So I didn't care. I just said, you know what, Karen, you can do this. I tell myself every day that you're going to make it. That's what I tell myself every day. So I guess that keeps me moving. So I didn't really care about those people's comments, my friends. Yes, but seeing it at the level, at the time that I started this and at the level that I've come to, my friends are proud of me.
Used car tires are the major raw material, and Karen adds a little more to beautify the end product.
I started talking to my aunties and uncles about it. And so when they would change the tires, they would bring them here. They would bring them to me. They would call me and tell me, we have tires. And then I'm like, okay. But because of the transport means, at times they could not manage to bring them. You know, they would just tell me, can you come and pick them? So even that was a challenge, because some of them stay in Gaza. It's really far to be carrying tires up to this side. So what I could do is that when I would get someone who wanted to buy a table, I would just go to their place and do the table from there. That is the beauty of this work. I don't have, because the ideas are here in my head, so I don't have to carry a book, I don't have to carry a word. No, I just have to carry myself and a bit of equipment and then go there and do what I want to do and turn the tire into what I want it to, how I want it to be.
Karen first sourced the tires from family and friends, but has now widened her scope into buying material from garages and many more places.
I found another way of getting the tires. I buy them like at 5,000 from the people who have tires. But as per now, I have somebody who gives me tires. So when I go there, he says, I have some tires for you. And then he gives them to me. Yes, after I pay. Definitely, yes. So that's how I get them. Because a 5K is like the least amount that I spend in making the tire. Yes, because the rest, the glass, the wood, the leather, it's more expensive than that. So a 5K wouldn't. I would add it to the bill of the custom.
From stone to paint and glass, Karen changes the entire look, and one would mistake her tire furniture for wood or even marble.
I get the tires and then I have some people who help me. I can wash, obviously, a tire, but then at times I need somebody to help me, especially when I'm at school. I need somebody to stand in for me. So I employ people part-time, like 4 guys part-time. Aside from the people who help me market here and there, employ 4 guys part-time. And then one of them will do the washing of the tires. Then when I come back, it will be easier because they'll be clean. So I'll be able to craft it into what I want it to be. But mainly I design the work. I don't do the wood, I don't do the glass. I do the tire work. Yes, I designed the tire into what I want it to be. So I'll either use glue or use a rivet gun, staple gun. Yeah, and then transform it into what I want it to be.
God above all, for Karen, it's been him from the start and the reason she keeps on sailing.
I have a couple of inspirations. Yes, my sister, but and of course the Holy Spirit, because I mean, at times I don't feel like it. At times I feel like giving up. There's a time where I was broke and I was in my room at hostel and I had a fountain, a water fountain. The one I sold to Chase Johnson Hotel in Muyenga. And I didn't have money, but yet I had this work. So I just break down and I'm like, God, I have this work and I don't have money. How can I not have money and yet I have this work? My fountain was worth 800 Ugandan shillings, but it was there and it was flowing in my room. And then I had a couple of tables. I had like 2 of them. So I just broke down and asked God to come in and help me because I was about to give up. But immediately I thought of the far that I've come and how many people look up to me and my future. So I just decided to go on.
Even as a student at the university, Karen has managed to juggle books and her passion, which is art and in this case, car tire recycling.
I'm somebody who doesn't want begging. I hate begging. And I believe that we're supposed to live a good life, even on earth. Yeah, it's supposed to be heaven on earth for us. Why should you suffer? So if I don't want to suffer, and I wouldn't want anyone to just give me something, or I mean to have to get money from men or things like that, so I just decided to work hard.
Car tire recycling is not a complicated process per se, and is done with simple but quite pricey equipment.
I use wood, glass, steel, stones, pins. You can use anything. Yeah, you can do anything as far as your mind lets you. Whatever you think in your mind you can do, eh? I believe you can actually do. Because I'm actually thinking of using braids.
For now, Karen only displays her work at home and at a few furniture shops around her home in Makindye.
Mostly, I work on orders. If somebody makes an order, is when I'll make a table, because I don't have a showroom really where I will leave them there and stuff, except for the places where I take them to, like for the different showrooms or furniture houses that I would put a piece or two in them. Otherwise, I don't think that I just have products there for people to see. Yeah, but well, except for sometimes when I feel like doing something, for you know, just making something, because there's a time where I feel that when I don't have orders and I want to make something.
There was a time when social media was considered by some as a passing fad, but over time, skeptics have been proven wrong, and that it's being used as a great marketing tool for small businesses just like Karen's.
I use Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, WhatsApp, and Google.
Whether you have one or 100 tires, there's always something that you can make with them that will not only repurpose them, but give you great interior and exterior deco.
Well, this table is unique, first of all, and it's durable. Yes, it is. Why I'm saying that it's durable, is that it's made from tyre. And tyres lie around everywhere. You know, they congest the environment and all that. I think they're close to polythene. Yes. So they are durable, and you will not find them in many places. So you will definitely want to buy a table like this.
Even to date, making car tire furniture has not been an easy path for Karen, just like she explains.
Customers making orders, and then they make changes. I don't want glass, I want wood now. Like what? Glass costs like 50,000 plus. So then I keep on thinking, what? What should I do? I feel like just go telling them, you know what, if you can't take this, then don't. I feel like reacting in a certain way, but I just get a hold of myself. I'm like, I just try to reason with them. I tell them, you know what, even this will work for you. So if the glass, you know, can't work for you, then top up a bit of money. I tell them, I make them see the better picture of this all. Spending a little more by getting what they want. Yes, and then the other challenge is market, locating market. Which is tiresome. It is. Because social media obviously will not bring you the right market, though I try to boost some posts on Facebook. But it won't bring you the right market, definitely. So the bit of finding market, big market, large market, like hotels and things like that, is really hard. You find that you have to go through somebody to actually get there. That they will not receive you as a person. They receive you and listen to you only because of somebody. I guess that's in Uganda, common in Uganda.
Hold on to your passion and do what you love. The rest will simply follow. These are some of Karen's parting words.
They should get out of their comfort zone. Sometimes it's not about sitting there and, you know, wanting a white collar job and all that. You have to make a decision to do something. To do something that is going to keep you occupied, but also to do something that is going to bring you money, because at the end of the day, you're not only going to support yourself. There are people you're going to support, like your family, your parents are aging day by day, so you can't sit down I just don't like people who keep on saying that, you know, government at West Saint. What's that? I mean, government at West Saint. Does the government feed most of us? No. In my family, they're business people. My aunt is a business people. My dad was a business person. And I don't know, probably you must come from, I think it also has to do with the blood and the environment around you.
The sky is just the beginning for this young budding entrepreneur.
I am definitely going to have a showroom. I want to have like a tyre village, tyre refinery, but a village, because I'm calling it a village because it's going to be a very big place where people, where also young people come and display their ideas and actually not only talk about them, but also put them to reality.
All tyres are normally thrown out or at the very least end up sitting around in the garage or yard collecting dust. Now instead of throwing them out or letting them sit there making your yard look cluttered, how about turning them into something useful?
Innovate takes a very short break, but we return with much more from the field of technology, both here in Uganda, as well as making sure that you are safe online while you use the internet.